Hey y'all, it's me Marty. Welcome to another video. And today I am going to show you one of the many lakes in Minnesota. So, I'm just going to tell you a little bit about this lake. And then I'm going to just ramble around the lake and just explore. And just see what I can see and what I can find and what I can enjoy today. Okay, so you're looking at Lake Ripley in Meeker County. It's Litchfield, Minnesota, just southwest of town. And we've lived in this area for about 24 years now. We live west of town now in Grove City. We have a little 2-acre hobby farm. But we lived in Litchfield for many years too, a few different places here. Nice little town, about 6,500 people. Anyway, this is Lake Ripley. So a little bit of history about Lake Ripley here. And I'm not a historian or anything. I just looked up some stuff and some things I know. A little bit about the lake, and then we're just going to go and explore and just have some fun. Okay, so this is Lake Ripley. It's approximately between 575 and 600 acres, and not a completely round lake, kind of a, I don't know what shape it is, but I'll show you a picture, maybe right here, somewhere in here. Anyway, and it's anywhere from 10 to 18 feet deep at the deepest point. It has a lot of different fish in here. There's walleye and northern and bass and crappie and sunnies, bullhead, perch. I think there's some sturgeon in here, northern pike, some different fish in here. It's a pretty good fishing lake. My wife and I have caught some sunnies, and I think we caught a couple of little walleye and bass just from the docks or from canoe. I've canoed on here a lot. We actually lived on the lake over here for a while. We rented a place a few years ago, but it has three parks, four technically, but there's one on the west side of the lake, it's Lady Bird Park, and then one on the north side, it's Lions Park, and then one on the east side, it's Memorial Park, and then there's another little park kind of right behind me over here by the campground. I don't think it has a name, it's just a little, has some swing sets and stuff, but yeah, there's basically four parks on the lake. There's two campgrounds, so there's one campground behind me, kind of on the southeast side of the lake. I think it's Ripley Campground, I think. And then on the west side is Spirit of Ripley Campground. It's actually across the road from the lake. There's two public accesses, one on the west side and one on the east side, right behind me here. Actually, there's a bunch of other places where you can get like a canoe or raft or small boat in. I've done that before. And it was named after Frederick Noah Ripley. And he was a doctor from New York City. And he moved to Shakopee, Minnesota back in 1840s, something like that, 50s. And he wanted to set up a medical practice over in this area. And there was a small town here and near Forest City and Clear Lake. Four cities just north of Litchfield, a few miles. Clear Lake, I don't know where that town was. I think it was just south of town here. I'm not sure, in Meeker County. Anyway, 1956, they were traveling, trying to go over to Forest City from Clear Lake, I believe, to get some medical supplies and supplies to set up a home and maybe a practice for his, he was a doctor. Anyway, it was a beautiful sunny day and it was snowy. It was kind of in the spring, I believe. And the snow was melting, so it wasn't real bad. But anyway, it started snowing, it got colder, and there was a whole blizzard. Anyway, Mr. Ripley, Dr. Ripley, ended up dying in that blizzard just like a half a mile from the lake here. And then they named a lake after him. So it's Lake Ripley, named after Dr. Frederick Noah Ripley. Hope I get that right. Again, I'm not a historian. I just looked up some stuff and just some different things I know. And yeah, I believe the town of Litchfield was originally named Ripley also. So, hey, and for my friend Steve from Nova Scotia, yeah, there's a lot of Ripley stuff here for you. Anyway, I just thought it was fun. Actually, my wife is at the doctor getting some therapy stuff and for like an hour or so, and I thought, I'm going to bum around and do something on the lake, and I thought I'd do a video. So yeah, that's pretty much everything about Lake Ripley here. There's a lot of residential around it. Again, there's a few parks, highway, just a two-lane, small highway, 22 run, or not, is it a highway or county road? I don't know. Anyway, it runs along the east side of the lake here, And on the west side, there's some geese over here talking to me, trying to be a part of the video. And on the east side is Highway 1. So two small little highway county road things. I don't know. Something like that. I'm going to go over here in the grass. And there's a lot of people walk around the lake. Let this lady walk by over here. I see a whole bunch of minnows in there. I'm going to see if I can catch this. I'm going to see that. Big school of minnows just went flying or swimming over there. Anyway, yeah, so there's a lot of residential here. And, oh, there's somebody in a big truck is parking over here. Truck driver. Where is he? I'm trying to see here. Anyway, he's right over there somewhere. He's going to park there, probably have lunch or take a break or something. Anyway, And yeah, there's also a garden area over here. It's called Anderson Gardens. Really pretty. We actually rented a house right next to the gardens over there. And yeah, there's a beach actually here too for swimming. A big park, kind of a little water park they put in a few years ago. That's about it about the lake. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the camera around and I'm actually going to get in the car and just kind of drive around the lake, stop some different places, walk around, look around the water, just do some exploring, look for flowers and mushrooms and just different things blooming. And yeah, it's about 50 degrees this morning and sunny. And yeah, I have like an hour before I pick up my wife again. So I'm just gonna explore Lake Ripley and just share a little bit of, about it with y'all. So here we go. So I'm still on the east side of the lake here. And some, oh, a whole bunch of minnows swarming here again. I don't know if you can see them. Where are they? A whole bunch of minnows in there. And I got some geese over there, kind of floating by. Quietly cruising by on the water. Oh, we got trumpeter swans over there. Two of them flying by. I'm gonna zoom in on them with a blurry. Good night. Those are pretty. I like their sound they make. Trumpety. Oh, we got poop. Poop alert, y'all. Poop alert. Yeah, you gotta love it. So I think there's at least a few creeks that come into the lake or out of the lake. I don't know how that works. And this is one here. I don't know the name of it, but it's the pretty little creek here. Oh, we got two geese walking out from the creek over here. Lots of reeds in here and yeah, here's that little playground over here, a little park. I don't think it has a name. It's just kind of next to the campground. But Oh, this would be a nice place to sit or even put a hammock between these two trees. Yeah, pretty flower here. So yeah, I'm on the east side of the lake looking west from here. I think these are aspen, these two trees, I think. Yeah. Oh yeah, see here, the creek's flowing out right here. Isn't that pretty? The sun and the different colors in the water there, and the rocks. Ooh, I gotta tell my wife about this. There's some pretty rocks in the water there. Flowing out into the lake here. I think they're communicating with some other geese over there. Okay, we'll keep moseying along the shoreline here. So I'm gonna go clockwise around the lake. Let's go over to the south side of the lake. Some more geese here. And there are babies there. Yeah, that's that little park there, and there's a campground here, right on the lake, Ripley Campground. Not many people there right now, middle of May. Another week, Memorial Weekend, this will be packed. So, there's basically, well, there's a couple of different roads you can take that actually go around the lake. You just got to turn off the different roads to stay going around the lake. And then there's, you could actually bike or walk all the way around the lake too. So, on some different bike paths. So, yeah, that's the campground there, and right here is actually another little place you can pull over. So this isn't technically a public access, but it's easily accessible with a canoe. And there's a dock there. It's actually the campground's dock, but my wife and I have actually fished on that dock and caught some fish. Oh, she usually catches the fish. I don't catch much usually. But yeah, another almost could be a swimming beach here. Go down here, there's another little creek coming into the lake. Ew. There's a dead fish. Ew. Yeah, so we're on the south side of the lake now. A lot of people just kind of drive around the lake, park different places. A lot of people walk around the lake or bike. Another little kind of creek or runoff or whatever running into the lake here. Yeah, ew. Dead fish in the sand. Different plants along the shore here. Driftwood and very pretty lake. So another thing, I don't know if any of you ever do any geocaching. It's kind of a fun game. My wife and I did it a few years ago. We haven't done it in a while, but you download an app and then you try to find treasures around the world. Actually, they're all over the world. And there's other games like that too that are just kind of, there's not really things that you find. It's all just online. what's the new one? Mimsy or Momsy or weird, something like that. But I like geocaching because you actually find something. There's a physical cache there. And, you know, you use the GPS and you try to find them. And then there's a thing there and you open it up and there's a little log in there where you sign your name and the date. And they're unique. There's all different kinds and stuff. And I actually did it for a while. And I think I did 100 geocaches. And most of them around Litchfield in this area, within an hour of here. And I haven't kept them up, and I haven't done it for years now. But we kind of quit geocaching. It was a reason. It was a way, kind of got us to enjoy the outdoors more. And now we don't need a reason. We just love enjoying the outdoors. But I say that because I have a few geocaches on Lake Ripley here. And I'm going to see if I can find them. I'm going to see if they're still here. And they're... I think the ones I did are all kind of woodworking because I do woodworking too. I think I have a bird. Well, I think I have a hummingbird and then a large dice. And then I think a blue jay. And I'm going to see if they're still here. So as we're going around the lake exploring, I'm going to see if my geocaches are still here too. Oh, there's some more geese flying by. You could actually hear their wings. That's neat. Okay, I did have a blue jay geocache in one of these trees. If it's still here. Again, it's been years since I've looked for it. People might have taken it, or it might have fallen on the ground, and who knows. I don't remember what tree it was in. It might be this one. Yeah, bug's getting in my ears. I don't see it. Keep looking. Be interesting if I still see them. Some nice big rocks along the lake here. Isn't that pretty how the sun is just shining on the lake and it's just little rippling waves? We went by yesterday and it was really wavy. A very pretty, peaceful day today. Now I'm kind of on the southwest side of the lake, and you know, the road kind of goes along the lake here. It's really slow. It's supposed to go only like 20 miles an hour. A lot of houses and cabins in here. So, I'll find the next place that I can pull over and explore down by the water. another little creek running through right here. Oh, that was a pretty good sized creek. There's nowhere to pull over there, otherwise it would have showed you. I think there's, I don't know, four or five creeks running into the lake, I believe. There's one that's named on the west side. I'll show you in a little bit. A lot of people walk and bike around the lake. It's about 4 miles around. And I biked around a few times. Actually, I think I did a video years ago. Going around the lake on my bike. Yeah, it's off and on rain the next few days. It is Monday morning now. We were going to go up north to the North Shore. We really wanted to. We actually had reservations at a campground. But we canceled them because it's like 100% chance of rain up there all week. So we'll do that another time. Just hanging out at home, doing stuff. But in between the showers, well, right now it's pretty much perfectly blue sky and sunny. We'll do things. Make some videos, do some chores, enjoy time outside. Okay, now coming around to the west side of the lake now. And this is another little highway, county road or whatever. But I'm going to pull over here. Go down by the water here. So here's the other public access. There's a dock here. It's like somebody's fishing here, so I won't bother him. I think I'll go down here. Well, you know what? I'm gonna just park here and go down by the water a little bit. Ah, now we're on the west side of the lake looking over east. And I did have a geocache over here somewhere too. Three flowers. I don't have my geocache app on anymore, so I'm not sure where my geocaches were, but I thought there was one in here. It was actually a large dice that I had made. I don't know. Anyway. Ooh, there's a pelican out there. Haven't seen many pelicans yet this year. Over by our house, by the lake by our house, and the ponds by our house, we have tons of pelicans in the summertime. I think they're just starting to come back from wherever they went. Looks like there's one sitting there. Yeah, actually, I think we're going to get a fishing license today. Maybe do some fishing next couple days. Now, there's lots of places where you can just get down by the water. Whether you want to just sit by the water. Oh, there's some fish there. You can see them there. So the sun's bright. I can't see if you all are seeing anything, but there's fish right there. Some small little sunnies or perch, I suppose. There's a whole little pile of them there. Looks like it might be little sunnies. Neat. But yeah, whether you want to just get down to the water, just enjoy, or fish, or even swim, pretty clean lake for swimming. Or you even get a boat in or a kayak or I. Yeah, it is a beautiful day. Oh, I suppose. Yep, yep. That's how I am. I do a lot of hiking, and I'm always making videos and taking pictures. Yep. And then over there, so again, we're on the west side of the lake. There's a pier there, a fishing pier. So you can fish off of that. I wonder where I had a geocache, a big dice. I don't know, whatever. I haven't kept up on my geocaches, so who knows whatever happened to them. Maybe all gone, or people took them, or they degraded. I mean, the ones that I made were all wood. Really kind of neat and creative, but I don't know what happened to them. Still on the west side here, just exploring. So yeah, this is the CSAH1, I don't know what that stands for, Highway 1 on the west side of the lake, and this is Spirit of Ripley Campground. It's kind of across from the lake, it's not on the water. This is West Ripley Park, also known as Lady Bird Park. So there's actually a lot of places around the lake to you know, have picnics and be by the water and fish and swim and picnics and, you know, all different things and family get-togethers and stuff. So I'm going to start going around the north side of the lake. Well, more on the west side and the north. But I'm going to pull over here because it's really pretty right here in this corner here. There's a creek coming through here. And just see what I can see along the water here. Lots of rocks here. Actually, my wife and I have stopped here before and she's looked for rocks actually in the water here. Really pretty rocks in the water. Rocks and kind of mossy stuff in the water, and again, I'm on the west side looking east. There's some traffic going by over there, and again, cars and people walking and biking go around the lake at different points. Ooh, this creek's moving. Oh, this will be pretty. So, oh yeah, oh this is pretty. Hey, look at that shell. I believe this is Jewett Creek. So I don't know. The lake's running out into the creek here. Is that how it works? Do they run out? Oh, look at the fish here. Gosh, those are actually, it could be a pound or half pound or pound. I don't know if they're perch or, I don't even see them. The sun is so bright, I can't tell what you're seeing. So, but there's fish there. There's a whole, like, school of fish right there by this tree. Huh. Yeah, those are... I think the other ones might have been sunnies. Those might be perch. I don't know. We better get our fishing license. Come over and do some fishing. Yeah, this is pretty when this is flowing. Sometimes it's just rushing. If we get a lot of snow in the wintertime and it melts, or a lot of rains in the spring. And it's been raining lately, so this is flowing pretty good. I'm gonna go down by the water on the other side. I bet it's really pretty over there. Oh, I love the sound of moving water. And we don't have a lot real close by us. Again, we live in West Central Minnesota, and we have over 10,000 lakes, like 11,842 at last count. And that's just over 10 acres. There's 20,000-30,000. That are smaller too, but we have to drive another hour, a couple of hours away if we want to see waterfalls or moving water. We do have the Crow River a couple miles away, but I'm gonna go on the other side of the bridge here. See if I can get down there without falling. Ooh, look, this is pretty. It's pretty. Okay, let's see how close I can get to this. I believe this is Jewett Creek. There's somebody's house there, so I don't want to go on their property, but... I'm gonna get down here without falling. Good night. Good night, y'all. Okay. Alright. Look at that. So... Ew, another dead fish.
Ew.
Look at that. Isn't that pretty? Look at this. As I'm standing here at this angle, I'm below the water of the lake. I'm below the lake right here in this creek here. I'm below it. The lake is coming under this bridge, which I was just on top. But right, I'm right... actually below lake level right here. That's pretty. Oh, I could sit here for an hour. And then it actually flows I think it flows west and north. Kind of towards where we live, that direction. Boy, I wish we had a creek by our house. We have a lake right across the road, but this is nice. Last time we were here, it wasn't really flowing, but it's flowing pretty good now. We've been getting more rains. I believe. Yeah, I don't know what I was going to say. I hate when that happens. You don't want to be looking that close at my face. So that's Lake Ripley. Creek flowing down. Pretty. Yeah. People living right here, they live right on the lake, and they also have the creek running right by their house. Boy, that would be nice. Pretty clear creek. I mean, it's not like it's coming out of the mountains or anything, but pretty clear here, not bad. Very nice. Yeah, we'll keep moseying on the west side over to the north side of the lake. Continuing along the west side of the lake. More houses over here, residential. Some big houses and some little cabins. Kind of a nice variety, actually. We know a few people who live on the lake here. So there's two ladies walking around the lake. I kind of keep catching up to them because I'm driving, and they're probably wondering what I'm doing. So now we're on the north side of the lake. I'm gonna pull over up here, another little spot, explore a little bit. It'd be neat to see some mushrooms or some more flowers. Now, I did have a geocache in here, too, but I'm not going to... It's hard to pull over here. There's not much room. But, yeah. Now I'm on the north side of the lake. Just a little mosey in the woods here a little bit. you know, so I'm making a video and enjoying the day by the lake as I wait for my wife to be done at the doctor, and I keep talking to people, and people keep talking to me, which is wonderful. We don't talk enough. People don't take time to talk. But yeah. Need to talk to people and just encourage and inspire each other. So there's actually a golf course on the north side of Lake Ripley here, too, so. And I think this is somebody's property here, so I'm gonna go back over here, get down by the water a little bit. Over on this side, on the north side of the lake, there's a lot of reeds. Which actually is probably the best place to fish on this side of the lake. A little gap here. Good night to get on the dock. I've seen muskrat and beavers in here before. My wife has actually got videos of snails and fish and all kinds of things in the water. Oh, see some small fish in there again. So now I'm on the north side of the lake. That's the east side over there where I started. That's the south side. That's the west side over there. A lot of variety on this lake. So here's a golf club here, a restaurant. It used to be a restaurant. And there's, we actually rented that house over there a few years back. But yeah, the golf course is on the north side of the lake. And this is actually Lake Ripley School, where my three kids went when they were young. And here's Anderson Gardens. Actually, Litchfield Cemetery is right there across from the lake. And actually over there on the other side of those trees is another house we rented for a while. We lived on the lake at two different houses we rented. So this is Anderson Garden. So I thought I'd do a little bit here because it's really pretty. There's lots of pretty flowers here. Beautiful trees. Everything I think is just starting to bloom. I don't know. And there's lots of memorials here too, which is kind of neat. I think these are, I know what these are. What are these called? I know what they are, I can't think of the name. Oh, these are pretty. Very pretty bush here. Flowers. Some things blooming, some things not yet. It's neat because they have trails through here. And there's benches. A very neat little garden park area here. Well, those are neat. I wonder what those are. Huh. They're pretty. Kind of a Dr. Seuss looking flower. And a neat. Tulips, maybe? I don't know my flowers very well. I know one thing. I need a restroom. I thought there used to be one in here. Yeah. Try to get these without my shadow being over them. Me and my shadow. It's neat in here because there's some sun, there's some shade, there's little trails going through here, and different areas of flowers, and a lot of these are memorials to people and stuff. And a little rock garden over here with some benches and flowers and plants. The garden shed. I thought there was an outhouse over here. Kind of hoping. Good night. Whoa, hello. Zoom out, Marty. Again, I'm not a professional videographer by any means. All kinds of plants. Hostas. The sign here, Hosta Hill. That reminded me. That one I've seen earlier is Hostas. Yeah, there's arbors and things here, benches. Hey, I think I just seen a little chipmunk. Hey, Chippy. Hey, Chippy, Chippy. I love chipmunks. They're like my spirit animal. Hi there. What you doing? Are you in the shade there? You sure are cute there, Chippy. Call all chipmunks Chippy. They're all Chippy. Oh, it's like... Oh. If you want to screenshot this and read it, I might do that later. There's a little history of Anderson Gardens I didn't even know. The Giving Tree. It's actually a good book. Huh. Very cool. Don't come over here very often. Should. Are these white lilacs, maybe? We just planted some purple ones, I think, in our yard. I was sure there was an outhouse in here somewhere. Maybe not. I might have to go find a tree. Good night. Hate to do that, but... I don't see anybody. Do I dare? Do I dare? Yeah, I dared. I had to pee behind a tree. When I gotta go, y'all. I just gotta do it. Now I'm down by the water here. On the backside of Anderson Gardens here. So yeah, now I'm on the northwest corner of the lake. Looking out. Very pretty. Yeah, finding lots of flowers and haven't seen any mushrooms today. But... lots of neat things by the water. I have a neat ramble around Lake Ripley. Skeeters. So I don't like summer. I don't like the heat. I don't like the bugs. But still try to make the best of every day and every moment and every season. That's a big tree. I think that's an aspen. Judging by the leaves. Pretty sure it's an aspen. That's a giant aspen. Good night. That's got to be 12 feet around. It's a big old tree. Whoa. Ground's kind of soft. These are the rains we got recently. Just looking at these old trees and stumps. Looking for mushrooms or anything. For fun, I want to learn mushrooms. Been looking more. Cool old stump there. Oh, almost tripped. Yep. Mosey on. Almost done. Kind of wind up this video in a little bit here. Okay, now I'm back over pretty much where, almost where I started, on the east side of the lake. Again, the cemetery's on the east side of the lake over there. There's Memorial Park up there. Oh, look at that again. It's just teeming with minnows. Hundreds of them. Thousands. Just down there a little ways is where I started, and I went all the way around the lake. Seen some neat things. I think I'm gonna end this video and get ready to pick up my wife from the doctor and then continue on with the day. Kind of a neat little ramble around Lake Ripley, Litchfield, Minnesota, Meeker County. Birds flying all around, fish swimming. It's a beautiful day the Lord has made. Yeah, make the most of every day, y'all. Wherever God has you, whatever's happening in life, do what you can. And yeah, hope you enjoyed this little ramble around the lake. And thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.